Antenna and wave propagation playlist. Here in this session I'll be going to explain spiral antenna, and to explain spiral antenna these are my session outlines, where I'll be explaining basics of spiral antenna first, then I'll explain structure of spiral antenna, then I'll explain polarization and current distribution of spiral antenna, then I'll explain designing of spiral antenna, and then after I'll be summing up this session by explaining few applications of spiral antenna. So let us begin this session with first point, that is basics of spiral antenna. So in basics of spiral antenna, basically spiral antenna is having two arms, as it is there with dipole antenna, and that is been connected in spiral shape. So it is having two arms and that is been connected in spiral shape. So that is what I'll be explaining in this session when I'll explain structure, so it will be more clear. And when we talk about spiral antenna, it belongs to frequency independent antenna family. The reason is, when we talk about spiral antenna, its polarization as well as radiation pattern remains unchanged over large frequency region. So its radiation characteristic is not changing with respect to frequency. So that belongs to frequency independent antenna family, where one can see polarization and radiation pattern of spiral antenna remains unchanged over large frequency region. So we can achieve ultra wide bandwidth by spiral antenna, and there are few spiral antenna which is available in the market that is having bandwidth, fractional bandwidth in terms of higher cutoff frequency divided by lower cutoff frequency, and that is about 30. So this is extremely wide bandwidth which is available with spiral antenna. So this type of frequency bandwidth that is available with spiral antenna. So this is what about basics of spiral antenna. Now let us move on to the structure of spiral antenna. So as we have seen, dipole that is having two poles, and length of this dipole that could be lambda by 2. For basic dipole, length is lambda by 2. Now when we talk about spiral antenna, what we can do is we can provide spiral shape to this two arm. Like, see, one can see here, this is my first arm. Now what I am doing is I'll be giving spiral shape to this first arm. So now see, this is what my first arm that has been given with spiral shape. Now this is what my second arm, that even could be given with spiral shape. So this is second arm. So this is what spiral antenna structure, where there are two things that we need to focus about. One is minimum radius R0, and second is circumference radius R, you can say RC, circumference radius. So here R0 is minimum radius, and RC, that is radius of circumference. So R0, that is minimum radius, and RC, that is circumference radius. So these two parameters are very important for designing. So that's why I have mentioned it over here. Now let us move on to next point of spiral antenna explanation, and that is polarization and current distribution. Now when we talk about polarization and current distribution, polarization of spiral antenna could be easily achieved for circular polarization. Usually spiral antenna is used for circular polarization, and there are some reasons, so that I'll be explaining in this portion. So let us consider one dipole, and let us say right now current direction that is in this. Now as current direction that is in this direction, what happens is you can easily see in this spiral, in this arm, current distribution that will be like this. That will happen like this. And when we talk about this second arm that is having current distribution, that happens like this. So if you see current distribution of two arms, that is completely in opposite direction. It is 180 degree out of phase. So current distribution here, current distribution is of 180 degree phase to two arms. And because of that current distribution, which is of 180 degree out of phase with two arm, we can easily achieve circular polarization. So by having that feeding mechanism of this simple spiral antenna, by connecting outer conductor of that cable with one arm and ground with other arm to this spiral antenna, we can easily achieve circular polarization. The reason is current distribution is of 180 degree out of phase to two arms which is there with this spiral antenna. Now when we talk about designing of this spiral antenna, so as I have told initially, there are two things which is there with spiral antenna. One is minimum radius. So minimum radius is R0, and circumference radius, that is RC. So here minimum radius is R0 and circumference radius is RC. Now based on that, we are delivered to design spiral antenna. Now one thing that should be clear to all, like see, spiral antenna radius, that is gradually increasing. So how does that increases? So here that could be designed by radius R, that is R0 into e to the power alpha phi, where if I place phi is equals to 0, you will be finding R is R0, that is minimum radius. So at phi is equals to 0, R is equals to R0, that is minimum radius. Now minimum radius, that will be justifying highest frequency of operation. So minimum radius defines highest frequency. Now how it defines highest frequency? So one can see here this radius, if you consider this dipole, then it is lambda by 2. So R0, that should be lambda by 4. So R0 is equals to lambda by 4, that is associated with highest frequency. So that is exactly, we can say lambda is equals to C by F. So C divided by 4, F, highest frequency. So based on that, we can say highest frequency, that is C divided by 4 R0. So highest frequency of operation, that has been defined by inner radius of that spiral, which is R0. So this is what the basic thing which we should understand when we design spiral antenna. Now second parameter, that is what will be the lowest frequency. So lowest frequency, that has been defined by largest radius, means circumference radius. So lowest means lowest frequency defines by highest radius, means circumference radius, RC. And that is what we define it based on circumference, that is equals to circumference that is equals to 2 pi RC, and that has to be lambda. Now lambda, that is C by FL. So we can say, based on that, we can say lowest frequency FL, that is C divided by 2 pi RC. So this is how we can justify what will be the lowest frequency which is associated with spiral antenna. So ultimately circumference of the spiral, that will justify lowest frequency wavelength. So lowest frequency wavelength, that is circumference, that is 2 pi RC, where RC is radius of circumference, and that will be defining lowest frequency. And that is how we can design spiral antenna with proper justification, identification of FL and FH. So this is what the basic thing which we need to focus when we justify what is the operation frequency which is there with spiral antenna. Now let us discuss few applications. So spiral antenna that could be utilized from 1 gigahertz to spiral antenna that could be utilized from 1 gigahertz to 30 gigahertz. So there are multiple applications which is available for this frequency range, and there are military aircraft applications. It could be utilized for microwave direction finding, as well as for ultra wideband applications we can use spiral antenna. So this is what all about spiral antenna basics understanding, radiation characteristic of spiral antenna. Now that is what the last thing that I'll be explaining. Now one thing that I forgot to mention here, that is radiation. So how to justify radiation? Now as we can see, this is what top view of spiral antenna, but if you see side view of spiral antenna, then you will be finding it's like this. So this is what spiral antenna side view. Now if you see radiation, then radiation characteristic that will be somewhat like this. So you will be finding radiation of spiral that happens like this. So this is how we can have radiation of spiral antenna. So this is what all about spiral antenna basics, radiation, designing applications, as well as polarization. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can suggest me those videos which is required to understand antennas and wave propagation. If I have knowledge based on your query, definitely I'll place videos to solve out your problems. Thank you so much for watching this video.